All right, well, there's a very unusual, one-of-a-kind exhibit in town involving microscopes dating as far back as the 17th century.
Of all things, to KMBC 9's Brenda Washington this morning. Brenda?
Guys, these are the most beautiful microscopes you'd ever want to see. You know, we don't really use the words beauty and microscopes too often in the same sentence, but these are something to see. Now, you probably have seen these flyers maybe around town, maybe in your newspaper, advertising the singular beauty simple microscopes from the Giordano collection, which is here at Linda Hall. Well, guess what? This microscope is right there, and it is a beauty. Bill Ashworth, who is the library consultant here at Linda Hall, is back with us. And briefly, tell us about that microscope. That's one of my favorite.
Well, that is one of the very earliest of the simple microscopes. It was made by a famous Dutchman named Christian Huygens, and it's designed to be held up to your eye and to be looked through. It just has a single lens in it. And as you see, it's gorgeous. It has an ivory handle. It's made of brass. It has a little spinning wheel inside, so you can put six specimens in it once.
But, of course, there are 126 other microscopes that you'll be able to see here. These are also fascinating. Right over here, Bill, you're calling these, flea microscopes? They are so tiny.
Yes, they're called flea glasses, and they were designed for the sole purpose of looking at fleas. Some of them, like this one here, have little boxes that you can put a live flea in. Some of them, like the one below, has a little pin. And if you're good, you can pin a flea on there, and you can see what this animal looks like.
And of course, over here, which I think is probably going to be a very big draw for this exhibit, is these are the microscopes designed by Charles Darwin. And of course, we have a picture of him right there. Tell us about these microscopes.
Well, Charles Darwin went on a very famous voyage, the Beagle Voyage, and took a microscope with him, which was very similar to the one that you see there by his portrait.
To the Galapagos Islands.
The Galapagos Islands and other places. And he was unhappy with this microscope because it didn't function too well aboard ship. So when he got back, he designed a better one, which you see at the bottom. And a microscope maker proceeded to market this instrument. And it's called Darwin's microscope, and it's sturdier, has a bigger case there for the for water. And so Darwin not only used microscopes, he designed them.
Okay, well, this is a very, very fascinating exhibit. I mean, we could go on all day and just show you some of the more unusual shapes and sizes and materials that they're made out of. But guess what? You get to see this for free yourself here at Linda Hall Library. The exhibit actually opens tomorrow, runs through September. If you go to our website, KMBC.com, go to News Links, more information about this exhibit. And again, it's free, free, free. So bring the family, bring the kids. It's fascinating and also educational. They've got two full rooms of all the microscopes you'd ever want to see.